So next we are going to see about the money bills. We have discussed about the ordinary bills and sales in enactment. The ordinary bills start from first reading and ends with the assent of the president. Now with the money bills, okay. So money bills are somewhat special. So what is the article covered for money bill? I have not mentioned articles while dealing with parliament because the articles are not very important in point of UPSC. So you can refer the book and you can study with articles, okay? But know the numbers. What is money bills? Article is 110. Okay. So what are money bills? Okay. What is the exact definition of money bills? Any bills, okay? Any bills having some certain criteria. The grounds are in your book, like the imposition, abolition, remission, alteration or regulation of any tax. Any tax that will come under the definition of money bills. Okay, you can't pass the regulation of any tax or alteration of any tax by an ordinary bill. It will come fit into the definition of a money bill. Okay, the regulation of borrowing of money by union government. If a government is borrowing from Japan or China, it will come under money bill. You should go through the way of money bill, not by your ordinary bill. Okay. Also, the custody of consolidated fund of India or contingency fund of India. There are many funds of India that will see. Okay, these funds, when you are taking money out of these funds, it will come under the this money bill. Okay, the funds are nothing but your home locker. In your home, you'll be having locker. No, your father's salary and your mother's salary will be placed in your locker. When you're taking, you'll get the permission from your house. No, like that to take the money from that locker of India, you should get the permission of the parliament. Okay, these things will come under the money bill. Like that, many grounds are here. You can refer your books for that grounds. There are some 8 to 9 grounds are there. Definition of money bills. So money means what? Finance. Anything related to finance. Anything related to the term money, literally the term money or related to finance means it will come under the definition of money bill. Okay, there is no exact definition of money bill. Okay, because it is depending on the government. Because for example, now Aadhaar bill is there. Okay, Aadhaar bill is a money bill. Okay, then how can I define the money bill? Aadhaar bill has been endorsed by the government as a money bill. So money bill is it is concerned with the respective government. Okay, so definition of money bill, it is not confined. Okay, it is a very holistic view for money bills, but have a little understanding that money means the term money or something related with finance will be passed as a money bill. That are the definition of money bills. Very important is what and all does not come under money bill. That we'll see. What and all does not come under money bills, does not come, will not fit, does not come. Okay, first is fees. Second is fines. Next is alteration by local community, local authority. So India, the government of India will have some fees. Okay, for example, for writing UPSC, you'll be paying a fees of 100 rupees. Okay, that will not come under money bill. Okay, like that, government will be asking fees. Okay, government fees will be there. No, that will not fit into money bill. Then fines. Okay, if you are not wearing helmet and your traffic police is fining you, means that and all will not come under money bill. So fees, fines, and alteration by local authority, imposition, abolition, remission, alteration, or regulation of any tax by your local authority also will not come under your money bill. Okay, which and all will come under money bill is present in your book. 9 grounds which and all will not come. These fees, fines, and anything, any alteration of tax by local authority also will not fit into this definition of money bill. Okay. That is important. Now we'll see very important thing. What is the speciality of this money bill? These are the speciality or the special condition or special criteria for a money bill. Money bill can be only passed in Lok Sabha, not in Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha has nothing to do with money bill. Only in Lok Sabha your money bill can be introduced. Okay. Next is with the recommendation of president. Only with the recommendation of president money bill can be introduced. That is second. Third is your money bill is a government bill. What is a government bill? I told, when a minister is passing a bill, it is termed as money bill. So your money bill is a government bill, which implies that only a minister can introduce a money bill, not a member of parliament. So these are the three important things for your money bills. Okay, so while studying these conditions of money bills, you have a comparison with constitutional amendment bill also. I have taught about your constitutional amendment bill. So have a comparison between your money bill's conditions and constitutional amendment bill's condition, because more or less they are same only. Okay, so important conditions: only in Lok Sabha with the recommendation of president, and it is a government bill. That is with important conditions of money bills. So now with respect to Rajya Sabha, we'll see. With respect to I told, money bill can be introduced only in Lok Sabha. It will pass through all the stages. So what is the presence of this Rajya Sabha with respect to money bills is, what are the options available to Rajya Sabha? Rajya Sabha with respect to money bills mean 14 days. What is this 14 days? I told, accepted means okay. It can't reject. Your Rajya Sabha cannot reject your money bill. So the money bill cannot be passed in Rajya Sabha, and your money bill cannot be rejected by Rajya Sabha also. Okay. It can return with recommendations, no actions. It can simply keep quiet. These three and four options is related to this 14 days. Whatever may be, it can return with recommendation, or it may sit simply, no actions. Everything should be completed within 14 days. Okay. This 14 days is very important with respect to Rajya Sabha. Okay. If a money bill is being passed in Lok Sabha, okay, it can only be passed in Lok Sabha, then it will go to Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is accepting, okay. If it is returning the bill, okay, with recommendation, it is up to the first, it is up to the Lok Sabha to either accept or reject. Okay. Whatever may be, that 14 days is there. Okay. Whatever you do, Rajya Sabha can do whatever it wants. One thing is very important. In terms of money bills, your Rajya Sabha is not at all having a function. In this 14 days only, they can do anything. That also with respect to Lok Sabha to accept the amendments or not. In this 14 days only, Rajya Sabha can function with respect to your money bill. Okay. That is with your money bills. So next we will see about the difference between an ordinary bill and a money bill. Okay. I have explained what is the money bill. Now we will comparatively study with the ordinary bill. Okay. So your ordinary bill can be introduced either in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, but your money bill only in Lok Sabha. Okay. It is your ordinary bill is either by minister or member, which means that your ordinary bill can be a government bill or a private member bill, but your money bill is strictly a government bill. That means only by a minister. Okay. Your ordinary bill can be introduced without the president's recommendation, but money bill only with the recommendation of president. Okay. With the president of the recommendation of president only, money bill can be introduced. Rajya Sabha maximum period 6 months. Rajya Sabha maximum period 14 days. What this means is, we know if ordinary bill is passed in Lok Sabha, means it will go to Rajya Sabha. Okay. And Rajya Sabha cannot do any action for 6 months. Okay. It can remain for 6 months without taking any action on that bill. If such 6 period is expired, means then it is deadlock happens, then it will go into joint sitting. Okay. In case of money bill, there is no joint sitting. Okay. In case of money bill, there is no joint sitting, because there is no need for a deadlock, because Rajya Sabha has no powers with respect to money bill. Because if it is passed in Lok Sabha and going to Rajya Sabha, in Rajya Sabha, only 14 days. In this 14 days, Rajya Sabha can accept the bill. Okay. Otherwise, it is saying any recommendations to the Lok Sabha, and if Lok Sabha is accepting or not, okay, anything, only 14 days, or Rajya Sabha is not taking any action for 14 days. In this 14 days only, Rajya Sabha can have this money bill. After the expiry of 14 days, either Rajya Sabha is passing the bill or not, whether it is returning or not, whatever may be, the bill has been passed. Okay. So one thing is very clear, Rajya Sabha is having zero powers with respect to money bills. Only in this 14 days, they can just pass the money bill. Okay. That's it. Can be rejected by Rajya Sabha, cannot be rejected by Rajya Sabha. Because I told, Rajya Sabha in money bill, Rajya Sabha is not having any pass. So it can't reject in money bill. But here Rajya Sabha can reject. Can be returned by president, cannot be returned by president. Here your ordinary bill can be returned by president, because without president's recommendation, this bill without president's recommendation, so he can return. But here it is already with the prior permission of president only, we are introducing the money bill. So how can the president return the bill? So there is no provision for returning the money bill. This is the exact difference between ordinary bill and money bill. And one extra difference is, while transacting this ordinary bill, when a bill passed from Lok Sabha to Rajya Sabha in terms of ordinary bill, there is no provision for the presiding officer of the house to endorse. Okay. But here in case of money bill, if money bill is going from Lok Sabha to Rajya Sabha, the speaker should endorse and countersign the bill. Okay. That is a slight difference also. So we have seen about the ordinary bills and stages, and what is money bill and what is the difference between money bills and ordinary bills. Next we'll see about the finance bill. What is this finance bill? It is nothing but very simple, same only. The definition of money. Okay. The definition of money. There are some grounds for finance bills also, but it is more or less similar to money bills. Okay. Only one point is very clear. Okay. Finance bill and money bills are more or less similar. all the money bills or finance bills. Okay, all the money bills or finance bills. But you can never say that all the finance bills are money bills. Okay, I hope you understand the meaning. All the money bills are finance bills, but not all the finance bills are money bills. Okay, so we'll see what is the relation between finance bill and a money bill. Okay, one thing, only in Lok Sabha, with president's recommendation. Okay, your finance bill is introduced only in Lok Sabha and with the president's recommendation. In this terms, in only in these two ground, in this only in these two ground, your finance bill is similar to the money bill. Okay, because money bill also only in Lok Sabha with the president's recommendation. In this two ground only, your finance bill is matching with the money bill. But all other provisions are similar like your ordinary bills. This only two provisions are similar between your money bill and finance bill, but all other provisions are same as what we are doing for the ordinary bill. Okay, that is with your finance bill.